Hello everyone, welcome to the biological database video. If you are a student or a teacher who is completely new to bioinformatics, consider this tutorial as a very basic guide or an explanation to the biological database. Hello everyone, today we will be looking at a biological literature database which is called as PubMed. PubMed stands for medical publications. So if you can read here, it has about 30 million citations for biomedical literature, and it is a part of Medline, okay, which is a part of NLM, that is National Library of Medicine, which is again part of NCBI, which is again a part of NIH, that is National Institute of Health. So PubMed is basically a database if you want to search any literature, okay, any journals, any books, any research papers you will get in this database, which is your PubMed database. So today let's explore PubMed. So if you see search PubMed, let's start with our basic thing, like what we do every time. Let's search for publications which is related to a disease, let's say cancer. All right, again you can see breast cancer, lung cancer. I'll go very specific, like let's say breast cancer, because if I just type cancer there will be millions of publications. Yeah, so this is what it is. I type breast cancer, I clicked on search, and here it is. I have about 414,799 publications which is there as of now. This is from 1789 to 2021. This is the year which is there, if you can see. All right, so these are the list of hits what we have got for all the research papers. Okay, this is just the top 10. Okay, like this we have 414,799 research papers. There is other ways also in which you can search for any papers. So suppose you have the you can search them by using, let's say, the name of the journals. So if I type Nature, all right, so Nature Reviews, I think that would be a better thing. So the Nature Reviews gives me, so it's 41,884. So these are the number of papers which has been published by Nature Reviews, all right. It has been published, and you can find them on PubMed. All right, so it's by journal you can search, by a disease in the first case, like breast cancer, you can search. You can also search in PubMed by let's say the name of the author. So I'll type my name, let's say Sanket Bapat. All right, so if I type, you can see the six of my papers which has been published in the past 5 years, which is there. All right, so let's look at one of the paper. All right, let us look at this machine learning paper. Okay, now when you click on this thing, this is how it's going to look like. So this is your name of that. This is your title. Okay, building an analysis of protein-protein interactions related to diabetes mellitus using SVM. So this is where we had analyzed some of the protein-protein interactions in diabetes using a machine learning method, and then we had performed text mining and network analysis on that. All right. This what you see here: computational biological and biology and chemistry is the name of the journal. This is the year. Okay. And this is where you can find the year and the month which it has been published in. All right. So another interesting fact is this thing. So that is 65, 37, 44. All right. 65 can be the volume or the issue, and 37, 44 is basically the page. All right. So this is your abstract of. Or the gist of the entire paper, what is there, some keywords and all right. And this is a part. Now if you want to actually cite this work, you can click here, okay, which is cite. It gives you the name of the authors, all right, all of them which is there, the name of the name, the title, okay, of the paper. Then it is from computational biology chemistry and year, and then there you have the date of issue link which is there. All right, so this citations is very good enough when you want to reference it in any research paper, what is there. So these citations can be of useful to you. All right, so now how to actually go to the actual paper, okay, the place where this paper is published. This is just in PubMed, okay, this is not the actual paper. Now you want to go to the place where the actual paper is published. So there you have to see here full text and links, okay. So you can click here, which is full text and links. When you click, it will redirect us to the journal, okay, where this paper has been published. So the journal is Computational Biology and Chemistry. It's volume 65. It's part of Science Direct, which is the main publication house. All right. And the year is 2016, pages 37-44. This is your title. These are the authors. Okay, this is me here. This is the DOI number. These are the highlights. So now they requested for highlights. This is the abstract. There's also a graphical abstract which you can download, which they had they wanted it. And then you have the various things. Okay, you have the highlights, keywords, and then you have the introduction and all of them. And you can also look at the figures which we had considered, or we had made for this thing. And then these are the tables also. Now, if you see this, this video I have made, it's targeted to all those students who are completely new to this field of research. Okay. This first year students or second year students who are completely new to this field of research, and they want to know how actually the research, what is a research paper, how it actually looks like. So it's for them. All right. And also for them to navigate through a PubMed and how does it really work. Okay. So before I end this video for your PubMed, I want to, give a very important piece of information to all the students who are watching this, because is that when you are searching for a publications, always refer PubMed, okay, because the publications which are there in PubMed, all these publications which you see, which they are cited in PubMed, all right, there's a lot of procedure, there's a lot of reviewing process which has gone for this publications to actually come in PubMed. This is how the PubMed actually really works. Hopefully you have understood this video. Thank you and bye-bye.